So that would tie the all-time record low. College Station, one below. Huntsville, one below. Cleveland, three. Columbia, West Columbia, 10. Excuse me, 11. Galveston going down to 18. And then high temps tomorrow stay in the 20s. Even Galveston at 31 stays below freezing tomorrow. Bush a high of 27, College Station a high of 21. Clouds will be on the increase late tomorrow evening as our next winter storm rolls in, so there's more to come. We're only in the early innings of this. Winter storm warning goes into effect Tuesday night through Wednesday and lasts through to 6 a.m. Thursday. That's the timing window of our next round of sleet and freezing rain, and it looks like that will be the threat. It will be sleet and freezing rain and not so much the snow that we had. Here's last night's jet stream as it dipped and gave us that winter storm. We get a break on Tuesday, and then it takes another dip going into Tuesday night and Wednesday. Another storm as it scoops up the atmosphere. We get lift on the lee side of the trough, and we're going to get another round of sleet and freezing rain. Now, exactly where the sleet, freezing rain, rain cutoff line is going to be is difficult to forecast. It's one we'll just have to kind of watch hour by hour, kind of like we did last night. This is Wednesday at 2 a.m., and you see the sleet and rain coming up the coast toward Houston, Galveston. This may begin as freezing rain down in Galveston. In fact, at 2 a.m. Wednesday, it will be freezing rain in the coastal counties. This will be sleet coming into Houston and our western counties, Fort Bend County as well, and then it expands. Now, the model Wednesday morning, 7 a.m., has a dividing line between rain, freezing rain, south of I-10, sleet, maybe also some freezing rain north of I-10 in Montgomery County, Walker County, Polk San Jacinto County, and our further counties to the north, and a little bit more snow up there in Dallas. That's Wednesday morning. So Wednesday morning, we're in the thick of it. Again, no travel. Wednesday afternoon, we might see areas south of I-10 get above freezing for a little bit. That would turn that over to rain. I think the northern counties stay below freezing, so that's likely sleet and freezing rain north of Houston Wednesday afternoon. And then we go into Wednesday night, we get a break, but early Thursday morning, the wee hours, still Wednesday night, Thursday morning, look at this, another jet streak overhead will produce enough lift to give us perhaps another round of sleet or snow in our north and west counties, Montgomery County, Grimes County, Walker County, up toward Madisonville and further north. So again, only in the early innings of this, we have several more days to go at risk for some sort of either frozen precipitation or bitter cold temperatures or a combination of both.
It's maybe an hour, you know, or two, you know, but nothing like this all day, you know, so I wasn't even stoked about it. I was like, okay, maybe, you know, maybe a few hours will pass and then everything will be fine.
Dangerous mix of snow, ice, and bone-chilling temperatures plowing through dozens of states. More than 130 million under winter alerts stretching from Texas to Maine. The cross-country chaos leaving behind slick roads. Some crashes even ending in flames as travel turned treacherous in Oklahoma and Mississippi.
The house is quickly losing heat.
The Lone Star State slammed with an unprecedented winter storm. At times, near blizzard conditions. In Houston, one county rushed to distribute nearly 8,500 shots before they spoiled after the storage facility lost power.
If you know.
In Kenner, Louisiana, a transformer blew out, sending electricity surging through the lines. This holiday weekend, ice and snow grounded hundreds of flights in Dallas-Fort Worth. In Chicago, snow falling up to 2 inches per hour.
This is an all-hands-on-deck moment.
And the extreme weather didn't end there. Seattle, the snowiest it's ever been in more than 50 years. The threat of tornadoes are now in the forecast, too. The Florida Panhandle and southern Alabama on alert. The Northeast bracing for freezing rain and ice overnight.
The Department of Sanitation has been running two 12-hour shifts. We've been working around the clock.
And we're not
sideways on a sheet of ice. And this Nashville couple surveillance camera capturing the moment they tumbled down icy stairs. And back in Texas, an unbelievable sight. The beach in Galveston blanketed in white, snow melting into the Gulf of Mexico.
Just incredible.
incredible images tonight, and this is really going to be an issue all week long with these multiple systems. Marcus Moore with us live tonight from Dallas. And Marcus, we know this kind of weather and days of dangerous cold all playing out in the middle of this pandemic. We learned the vaccination sites were forced to close in many places, as you pointed out, and with the power problems, now we've learned of a facility holding vaccine, losing power in the Houston area.
David, officials in Harris County, they scrambled to give out more than 5,000 doses of the Moderna vaccine after that facility lost power, and then the backup generator failed. They feared those doses would spoil, and they had to get to large groups of people fast. So they went to a couple of hospitals, a university, and even the county jail.
If you have a home to go to. And now again, if you need help, call 311 and the city will get you to one of its other two shelters at Baylen Park or the Judson Community Center. Those are open to everyone. And some of the
as we head on into Friday, plus bitterly cold wind chills for 54 million people from the plains to the Gulf that last right on into the weekend.
Power from other grids. At around 1:15 this morning, we moved to level 2 to reduce the demand by blacking out large customers. Here at 6 o'clock tonight, this is where we are, on level 3, where they are rotating the blackouts until the system can recover. So now we're just waiting as those crews are working hard to get the power restored. So just hang on, friends. Hang in there and try to keep warm. There are 1,000 customers without power. And, of course, this is giving us the statewide power. And also here in Harris County, all the electric providers for Harris County right now, more than 290,000 people without power right now. So I know a lot of you have been asking the question, you know, what happened? How did this happen? How did we get here and how do we fix it? Well, we've been asking those questions too. So this is how we got here. The cold, it was so cold out, it knocked down the power plants, causing them to suddenly go offline. Now look at this here. We were already behind the curve because some of those plants were already offline for maintenance. Now at home here in Texas, 75% of the state's generation comes from here. But half of the wind generation, you see there, 23% wind, 43% natural gas. But half of that wind generation is offline right now because it's too cold out there and those spinning turbines are literally frozen now to the natural gas. This is the major problem because everyone is using it right now, trying to keep warm, and the system is overwhelmed and overloaded, and they just can't keep enough power pumping to the plants.
Conceivable that you could be without power throughout the rest of today and possibly even going into tomorrow.